Welcome back everyone. So object.assign is another important method which is introduced in ES6. You can see object.assign, it takes n number of arguments. You can pass the multiple objects, but generally we use it something like this whenever we need to create a deep copy, right? So what assign method is doing, it is having some one single property. So it is taking two arguments, target object and source object. So in source object, you define your property, your stuff. So it will create a deep copy and give you this target object, a newly created object, which will be a deep copy. Okay, it will be, its proto and prototype will not be linked with the source object. So whenever we need to do a deep copy or create a fresh, brand new copy of an object, we don't do just x equal to y. Okay, this is the reference copy and you always end up in a problem. When you are adding a property to the y that is available to x, x is updating property that is available to y. So we need to do object.assign and create a target object from the source object. Okay, other uses of object.assign is just merging the objects, like this is one of them. Here we are actually merging the two objects, and it will be Tony Stark. Chrome sample is so it should be console.log. What is this? It's defined nowhere. Yeah, first name and last name, we are getting this value. So object.assign here, it is doing a merging. Foo1, so it is merging from right to left to left. Baz2, it's overriding the property from right to left, but it both are different, so it will merge it. Similarly, with the first one. So with the first merge, there will be bar and baz. Then it is going to override with the first argument. That is also a different property, so it will merge with this. So final argument is something like this. But here, foo2 will override the foo1. Now, till now the value is foo2. Now, foo2 will override the foo0. So, it will be foo2. So, object.assign is a plain and simple, and there is, I mean, we are using it extensively in our daily, day-to-day coding, writing the code in either React, Angular, everywhere, or in the Node.js.